Good evening, Cardinal Spellman. Welcome to the graduation ceremony for the class of 2020. Tonight, we celebrate this outstanding senior class in a most unique way as they officially complete their high school career at Cardinal Spellman and launch into the next chapter of their lives. We are confident that they are ready for their future, having been so well prepared by a faculty and staff who truly gave all they had in service of them. Now, please join us as we proudly honor the graduates of this, the class of 2020.
Cardinal Spellman, please join me in praying for the class of 2020. May the Holy Spirit of Jesus walk with you as you come to the end of one road and begin your new journey. May the Holy Spirit of wisdom guide you as you face new challenges and make God-inspired choices for your future. May the Holy Spirit of courage strengthen you as you go forward with hope and joy, trusting God in all things. May the Holy Spirit of love surround you as you continue to grow in wisdom and grace on this day and always. And may Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. God bless the class of 2020.
Greetings, Spellman families, Spellman faculty and staff, Spellman alum, and most importantly, Spellman class of 2020. It is my distinct honor and privilege as your principal to officially begin these rather unconventional but no less meaningful festivities as we celebrate this most significant day in the lives of 117 amazing graduates. Let me tell you something. You will not be remembered as that poor, unfortunate class of 2020. That will not define you. It will distinguish you, but not in the wake of pity, but in the reality of pride for how well you have handled things and how you will emerge with strength and resilience and courage. We have learned and used words that were never part of our vocabulary a few months ago. Words like quarantine, isolation, unprecedented times, and even Zoom. But rest assured, these words will not be attached to the class of 2020. No way. That will not be your legacy. Your true legacy will be one that has been built over the past 4 years. You are the class which your teachers describe as surprising, eclectic, compassionate, exuberant, faith-filled. You are the class of extraordinary leaders like Anthony and Caroline and Roshan, Savannah, and Jordan. You are the class of exceptional athletes like Craig and Will and Laura and Madison. You are the class of gifted performers like Courtney and Nathan, Kevin and Jamel. You are the class that exudes kindness, respect, and mutual support. You are the class that cheered Abby Tropiano on when she finally came out of her shell and belted out Sanctuary at last October's Mass to everyone's amazement. You are the class of pure goodness and positivity, the class with a heartbeat for servant leadership, lived out every day by people like Mike and LeBrant, Brianna, Audrey, Diego, and Mary Kate. And the list goes on from A to Z, and that includes you, Joe Zaborski. Yes, you are the class that got ripped off in your senior year, but you handled it with class and with selflessness and perseverance, and above all, with hope. And so, let us begin this celebration for you, this unique graduation ceremony for this unique group of graduates. Here's to you, not the unfortunate class of 2020, but to the truly extraordinary and beloved class of 2020. Here's to you. God bless you all. And now, a brief message from Cardinal Spellman's Chairman of the Board, Mr. Kevin Kelly.
Let me join the chorus congratulating the class of 2020. You sure didn't expect this type of celebration. As 2020 dawned, just a few short months ago. No one saw how events would unfold. That was then and now is now. Experts frequently and independently observe, regardless of their expertise, we have never seen this before. This young century has seen its share of the unexpected. You know, you are the children of this young century. On 9/11/2001, we experienced a terrorist act that killed over 2,000 civilians in New York City. In September of 2008, we experienced a financial collapse that led to the Great Recession. The classes of 2002 and 2009 each had to deal, adjust, and adapt to this version of the unexpected. As these classes overcame their challenges, so will we overcome the adversity created by the coronavirus and this global pandemic. This pandemic has put its exclamation point on the class of 2020. You are living and experiencing that unexpected. Make something positive out of that exclamation point. The character you have developed at Cardinal Spellman, knowing what is right and bravely acting to do it, along with mental toughness, will push you to grow personally and serve others in a deeper, richer, and even more thoughtful way. Living in a world where the unexpected is the norm, adversity must be faced head on. Let that exclamation point guide and inspire you so that you can leave your mark on this new and different world. The world of tomorrow will always be different, but will it progress? Be a force for that possibility of progress. Let the mark you leave, inspired by this adversity, define who you are.
Thank you, Mr. Kelly. And now it is my distinct pleasure, as president of Cardinal Spellman High School, to welcome this year's valedictorian, Gabriella Boutier.
Good evening. It is my great honor to stand before you all today as the valedictorian of Spellman's class of 2020. I would like to give a sincere thank you to President Hodes, Mr. Kelly, Mrs. Evans, Deacon Joe, all of our teachers and staff, past and present, and most importantly, our parents and families. Without each and every one of you and your constant support, we would not be celebrating today. To my fellow classmates, given the past few months, I cannot believe that we are finally here. To be honest, I have pictured this moment since I walked through the doors of Spellman on my first day of freshman year, but I never imagined it would be quite like this. Despite what Mr. Kelly said, most likely we will be remembered as the Corona class of 2020, but like he said, we will not be defined by it. This pandemic has proven our strength and resilience as a class, and we will not be defined by the single moment or the single struggle, but by what we have accomplished during all four of our years at Spellman. As I reflect back on my time here, I realize just how much we have relied on prayer. In addition to the hard work and dedication it took for me to be able to stand before you all today, I will admit that there was an awfully large amount of prayer involved as well. Especially in this dark and fearsome time, we all need to unite in prayer, as we have done so many times within the walls of Spellman. I encourage you all to take this time at home with your families to become better, not bitter, a saying that my family uses often to keep us focused on how blessed we truly are. Despite all the uncertainty in the world right now, one thing is for certain. Nothing, not even this virus, can take away the fact that after today, you are now a proud Spellman graduate. I look forward to the day that we can celebrate in person, but until then, I leave you with this. Life isn't about waiting for the storm to pass. It's learning to dance in the rain. It sure has been raining a lot lately, but I am positive that our future is bright, class of 2020. As long as we always remember where we came from, where we are going, and to always pray. Thank you, and congratulations, graduates.
Oftentimes, in life we are faced with challenges not of our making. challenges that force us to reevaluate how we live our lives and go about our daily business. The coronavirus pandemic has been one such challenge. We have all had to adjust, to shift, to pivot, to a new normal that has, in many cases, asked more of us by asking us to do less. Online learning is not easy. Staying at home is not easy. And even social distancing is not easy. But if this crisis has taught us anything, it is the power of the human connection. In the absence of this connection, we have collectively recognized its immense importance to us as human persons. We have sought this connection out in the only ways that have been available to us: Zoom, Portal, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, and yes, even graduation parades. It is clear that we were never meant to walk this journey of life alone. We were meant to share it. And in doing so, to meet and to conquer any challenges that we face, not alone, but as a collection of uniquely gifted and talented individuals, bringing their collective power to bear against any and all adversaries. I mentioned earlier the words pivot and shift and adjust. This was not accidental. These words are used frequently in the world of sports, and specifically in the world of basketball. Recently, you may have had the good fortune to tune into the ESPN documentary The Last Dance, chronicling the career of Michael Jordan through the lens of the 1997-1998 championship season of the Chicago Bulls. It is amazing to watch how Jordan himself had to adjust and shift and pivot so many times in his life and career when facing new challenges, and how ultimately his championships were only won when he worked as part of a team, and his team only won when they worked with him as an individual. Jordan struggled to find success early in his career as a team, until new coach Phil Jackson asked him to start to work with his teammates, implementing something he called the triangle offense, where Jordan would hand the ball off more and harness the collective talents of his team. As a result, the Bulls won 3 championships in a row, 1991, 1992, and 93. And then Jordan retired from basketball to pursue a career in baseball. And not surprisingly, the Bulls did not return to the championship game until Jordan left baseball to return to them in 1994. Following his return, the Bulls went on to win 3 more championships in 96, 97, and 98, for a total of 6 championships and 2 different three-peats. Michael Jordan learned that he needed the Bulls, and the Bulls, in his brief absence, realized they needed Michael Jordan. It was the absence that so clearly demonstrated the need for presence. We too at Cardinal Spellman, as we walk through empty halls and vacant classrooms, realize that it is only when we all come together that each of us individually, like Mike, can maximize our potential. This is echoed in our mission statement and lived even virtually here tonight. The power of the human connection, and specifically the power of the Spellman connection, is now more palpable than ever. And while we may not win the next NBA championship, we gathered here tonight count ourselves even more blessed to be with each other. Congratulations, graduates. And never forget your teammates throughout this unique time in human history. And never forget the lessons learned either, that we are a human family, that we need each other, and together we can do anything.
Class of 2020, it is a special honor to present you to the community as the graduating class of Cardinal Spellman High School. I wish you all the best of God's blessings as we send you out into the world. I pray that as you go forth on your journey, something you say, or something you do, or some way you have of being, will touch those around you with the love of God that shines so brightly through you. Wherever you go, whatever you do, have faith in God, and know that you will never walk alone. As assistant principal, it's my duty and privilege to present the members of the class of 2020. These young men and women have completed the course of study required for high school students by the Department of Education of the Archdiocese of Boston. They have been approved and recommended by the faculty and await their diplomas. The following students have been awarded diplomas:
Alexandra Elaine Achenbach, Keanu Gomes Alfama, Jeffrey P. Alti, Damari Kobe Amato, Julia Grace Ambrose, Julia McLean Anderson, Donovan C. Archulis, Grace Anna Armstrong, Nolan S. Barry, Paige Elizabeth Boisclair,
Sabrina Grace Borgard, Gabriella Ann Boutier, Michael John Bowen, Sage Brianna Brutiniti, Lily Anastasia Burke, Yamari Saray Burns, Romald Jonathan Cadet, Richard Paul Seant, Bahina Venia Charles, Claudel F. Chevalier,
Ryan C. Connolly, Carolyn Mary Cook, Griffin Francis Cornyn, Madison Elizabeth Cummings, Julia Z. Dandro, Alyssa Aradia Dansby, Mary Catherine Darcy, Audrey Lynn Della Barba, Jamel I. DeGrat, Brianna N. DeMuzio,
Jack Christopher DeSangro, Sean P. Donahue, Aiden Michael Doyle, Jordan Alexa Dye, Grace Leah Elizabeth Etienne, Craig Michael Faria, Zaire Armani Fernandez, Marissa Fernandez, Molly Mabel Farrow, Michael James Finneran,
LeBrant Shehan Fleming, Shane P. Foley, Mackenzie R. Frabetti Merlino. Madison Riley Fry. Jaden S. Germana. Michael Thomas Glass. Diego Antonio Gonzalez Teles. Gianna Francesca Grillone. Rocco G. Grillone. Courtney Ann Grzybinski.
Savannah Barham Grzybinski. Kylie Ryan Hall. Parker Thomas Hall. Robert David Hamilton. Mariah Saray Harris. Alexandra Lauren Holbrook. Roshan C. Isidore. Skylar Gabrielle Jacques. Wanshan Annie Jean. Matthew Hartnett Kelly.
Maxwell Hartnett Kelly. Caitlin Mary Corey. Jessica Suzanne Knight. Amanda R. Kolbinski. Ashley Elizabeth Langan. Victoria D. Lasandrini. Zamung Lee. Jingyaha Lee. Nicole Marie Lincoln. Rachel L. Lomasny.
Madison Elizabeth Loney. Brianna Yvonne Lubin. Jennifer Ann Lynch. Jovan L. Marrero. William Charles McAlpine. Stephen William McBride. Caitlin Elizabeth McNutt. Aranza Daniela Melendez. Sneet Tesfaye Maresi. Ava Elizabeth Moliere.
Kevin John Monahan. Brian Arthur Monet. Shaheem Moore Fernandez. Colin Matthew Mullen. Allie Rose Murphy. Anthony James Nardelli. Joseph H. Nguyen. Colin Christopher O'Keefe. Johnny Boy Otero Jr. Nathan A. Pacheco.
Chanel M. Paul. Allison Marie Pearson. Trevor Phillips. Joseph Redmond. Ethan J. Reyes. Jaden O'Neill Robinson. Elaine A. Rodriguez. Victoria Rose Russo. Ryan S. Sanchez Garcia. Alex F. Satirio.
Mara Rose Sexton. Hunshan Nemo Shea. Evan John Souza. Brenna Nicole Sullivan. Thomas B. Sullivan. Olivia Mary Sweeney. John T. Tedeschi. Delia Marie Tibbetts. Abigail Christine Tropiano. Victoria Ann Uzel.
Andrea Nicole Vieira. Peter Nguyen Vu. Leah Dora Willis. Mackay L.M. Woods. Joseph Benedict Zaborski. Mingza Paul Zhu. Jeffrey P. Zaniti.
It is my distinct pleasure to present the graduating class of 2020.
Good evening, Spellman. My name is Anthony Nardelli, and I'm the Student Government President. I would like to begin in gratitude to our teachers, who provide us with the inspiration and education, all the while creating special relationships with us that for some will last a lifetime. Thank you to the administration and faculty for making the tough calls and decisions so that we can study in a better environment and truly reach our potential. Thank you to Mr. Kelly and Ms. Evans for always having our backs and keeping us in mind during the tough times. To our families, who provide us with the love and support, especially over these past few months. And to the class of 2020, who without each and every one of you, these past 4 years would not have been possible. These past few months have been filled with uncertainty and worry, but what I can tell you is that this is quite a unique time to be an educated and inspired young adult. The world is changing, and who knows what it's going to be like after this pandemic runs its course. As graduating seniors, we have a field of opportunity in front of us, and it's wide open for the taking. To our peers going into the medical, engineering, law, and business fields, the possibilities are endless. The research at your desired university or college is waiting for you to discover new things so that when the world does change, it's in a positive way. Our generation of students is the one that is going to steer the world into the future. Mr. Kelly asked me to inspire the audience today, and being an 18-year-old boy who hasn't been out in the real world, it's a daunting task. So I thought I'd share with you what Spellman has taught me, and hopefully most of you. Somebody once told me that the person that gets the most out of high school is not the person with straight A's all 4 years, but the person who went from a C+ to an A-, or a D+ to a B. You see, high school in general has taught me one of the best lessons in life, how failure brings success. We have all faced challenges in high school. Sports, academics, friend groups, Miss Jenner's office, you name it. But we've worked through these challenges to be here today, graduating. Life is full of adversity, and the sooner you learn that in order to succeed, you are going to fail, the better off you will be. Now, there may be a few of you out there that have never outright failed. But for those of you who have taken a class in Room 105 with Miss Connors, you will inevitably learn what it is like to fail. See, the thing is, you are going to fail the first quiz, but if you do your homework that night, and of course, come back with your questions ready, you will slap adversity right back in the face and hopefully get a good grade on the next quiz. See, that's life. You're going to have good days and you're going to have bad days. But you can't be afraid to fail. And when you do, you need to pull your socks up and soar like cardinals over the challenges you face. Now, I understand that failure is not exactly the word you want to hear in an inspirational speech. What I'm hoping you hear is the fact that no matter how hard you go down in life, you will always bounce back harder and higher. So, Spellman Class of 2020, we are special. We have left the most unique and profound mark on Spellman. Let's not be remembered as the coronavirus class, but let them remember us as the class that went on and took advantage of the changing world. Let us be the class of new medical advancements, the class of new laws and devices to better one's health. Let them remember us as a senior class that did not get to go visit their dream schools in the spring, but then went on to do great things and even better things in life. Remember, it's okay to be knocked down in life. I mean, look at us. We were just knocked down pretty hard, but we're still here. We're still graduating. And I can tell you this, we are a resilient class with big dreams. We are going to do great things. So, Spellman's class of 2020, sequer deum, and I wish you the best of luck in the future.
And so, we bring this ceremony to a close, and we do so with great pride and admiration. This is your time. There are so many motivational phrases we could leave you with. Go make a difference. Seize the day. Remake the world. Be true to yourself. But there's one phrase that we hope you will always carry in your heart, and one that will direct your every decision in life. Your alma mater motto, sequer deum, follow God, now and forever. Amen. Congratulations, and God bless you always.